Hello, Internet. I'm Matt Haas. Google has done something awesome that pertains directly to you. It pertains to everyone on the Internet. I know this is a show about YouTube, but Google is part of YouTube and you have a life online, and this is important. Let's take a look at this NPR article that says you can now ask Google to take your personal data out of its search results. Okay, this is big. Google is offering a new tool to anyone who doesn't want their phone number, email, or street address and other personal information to be found online. People can ask for their contact details to be stripped from search results. Now, Michelle Chang, Google's global policy lead for search, says the availability of personal contact information online can be jarring. She also noted the data could result in unwanted direct contact or even physical harm. Now, this policy, they've lowered the bar. You can more easily make Google take action. They always had ways to deal with this stuff if there was a real impending threat or strict identity stuff. They've always were quick to do that. But now you can get this process started even if there's no clear risk. So let's take a look at this. This was their formal announcement on the Google blog itself. And they've got a request removals link here, which takes you to the help center. And then the button down here to get started. Before we jump into this, I just think it's important to go over what they'll take action on. If this is your stuff and it's online, they'll take it off. ID numbers from government, bank account numbers, credit card numbers, handwritten signatures, identification docs. So it's some serious stuff. This isn't just, oh, there's a funny picture of me, I want it removed. No, it's got to be something like that. And if you were doxed specifically, there needs to be an explicit or implicit threat or a call to action against you. So just keep that in mind. The removal request process is here. You can answer some questions of what you want to do in the search results and what action you want to have Google do if it's search results and on a website. So you can come down into these and choose what you want to happen. To happen there. And then they do ask if it was on a website, if you've contacted the site owner, and then here's the stuff where you can get going. So if these pertain to you, you click the item that is relevant, and then you can take it from there. So just follow the instructions. Again, they've lowered the bar. If your stuff is out there and you don't want it on Google's properties, like Google search results, everyone uses Google search results. Now you have a way to take it off. If this was helpful, drop a big old like. And if you're not on my email list, get on it. I give a lot of free stuff away there, and it's my primary way to communicate directly with you. It's pretty awesome. I'd love to see you on there. Thanks, Internet.